HTC Vive Focus 3 Virtual Reality Helmet is a model that's aimed at business users. The main difference between the device and many other analogues is that it can function in a completely autonomous mode. All you need is already built in here: a Wi-Fi module, accumulator, and even an active cooling system. That is why the helmet can be used without connecting to a computer or smartphone. If you connect the helmet with a third-party cable or via Wi-Fi to a computer with installed SteamVR application, you will have access to the catalog of games and entertainment from the cloud. The helmet is delivered in a large cardboard box. The package includes two controllers for right and left hands, USB-C cable with branching for parallel connection of both controllers to the helmet, powerful charger, a lens cleaning cloth, and a short user manual. The helmet looks massive, but its body is made of magnesium alloy, which allows you to minimize the weight without losing in endurance. The helmet consists of two main parts. In the front part, which is located on the side of the user's eyes, there are lenses and electronics. In the corners on the front side of the helmet, there are four cameras tracking the movement of controllers around. To move safely, users can turn on the end-to-end vision mode, which provides transmission of images from external cameras. The two lower cameras on the front side of the device form the black and white image. A soft pad with foam filling that comes into contact with the user's face is attached with the magnet and can be easily removed for cleaning. On the left, under the soft pad, there is an inconspicuous micro SD card slot, which allows you to expand the storage space. To adjust interpupillary distance between the lenses, use the dial that is located in the middle of the bottom side of the visor. Special adjustment lines appearing on the screen when using the dial help to find the optimal ratio. Near the wheel under the lid, there is a USB-C connector that allows you to connect peripherals, in particular controllers for charging them, and a computer for data exchange. The helmet speakers provide good sound insulation and surround, but directional sound, so people nearby do not hear anything. At the same time, a complete illusion is created for the user in the helmet that the sound is outside and not inside the head. A rocker arm regulates the volume level in the helmet speakers. On the left side of the visor, there is a menu button. And on the right, there is another USB-C port and a mini jack connector for a wired headset. On the helmet's rear, there is a handband side adjuster for a better fit to the head. You can turn on the helmet by long press on the power button, and the short press activates the LED indicator of the battery level. There is also a pin connector for the charger cable. The battery in the helmet is removable and acts as a counterweight to the visor, ensuring an even distribution of mass. The controllers are symmetrical for left and right hands. The set of buttons in terms of their shape and location is identical, but their functionality is different. Analog trigger buttons are located on the sides and under the index fingers. They are very important not only for shooting games, but also for navigation, because they work like pointers. Side triggers are used to grab virtual items. The controllers are charged via USB-C connectors located at the bottom, at the strap attachment. The movements of the controllers in space are tracked by the visor cameras in the infrared range. When shooting in the IR range, it is clearly visible that infrared light sources are embedded in the outer surfaces of the controller rings. For the fastest and easiest device setup, it is recommended to install the Vive Manager mobile application. The helmet comes with several pre-installed applications. Among them are the Firefox browser, in a special version for VR devices, and Vive Business Streaming. You can also install other apps from the Business App Store. For clarification, we connected the helmet to a computer over a Wi-Fi network and displayed an image on the monitor screen that the user sees in a virtual environment. In Firefox, you can run 360-degree videos from YouTube and just visit regular sites. In the Louvre application, you can take a virtual tour of the famous museum and look at the digital copy of the Gioconda. The Vive Business Streaming application is required to connect to a computer and use Steam VR. The Vive Sync application is available to business users. With its help, you can hold virtual meetings, demonstrate presentations remotely, and speak using an avatar. Note that the drawback for the autonomy and high performance is a low, flat, but distinguishable noise of the helmet cooling system. In general, the HTC Vive Focus 3 helmet makes an impression of a well-thought-out design in terms of hardware, adequate to the tasks assigned to it.